Fans are buzzing. Teams are gliding into position here for the start of the third. I'm surprised I've got a voice here in period number three after all those goals scored through the first 40. The Penguins will play it in their own end. Here they come on the attack. Fires it, and a great save. Moves it quickly over to Kapanen. Oh, and another stop.
Bang, bang, two unbelievable stops. One right after the other. He's got no help from anyone in front of him. He's got to do it all himself.
Lots of time left in this period. We got a tie game. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Lindholm's taking it from his own end. Feeds it on over to Terry. Puck grabbed by Zegras. And he slides it quickly to Drysdale. And the puck dies with the trapper save.
Right from the most dangerous area on the ice. The goalie flashes the glove. That's an arrogant stop.
Both centers ready to take the draw here coming up. The Ducks win it. Oh, some strong physicality on the play. Malkin's lugging the puck. And now he angles it across to Bluger. Good reach of the stick to knock the puck away. Here's a short pass to Rust. Takes the feed. Long jam in front. That's broken up. Lindholm stick handling in his own zone. Anaheim's in on the offensive attack now. Centering pass! A blast! Gets in front of it. Kanisov's got the puck along the wing. Long reach breaks up the momentum. And now it's grabbed by Bluger. Through the neutral zone, up along the wing. The Penguins gain possession in their own end.
McTavish has got a great ability to hang in the play. Like that last one, James, he looked like after he stumbled, he was out of the play. Yet he gets himself back in position to get a pretty good chance on goal.
We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. It's all tied up. Anaheim's got possession here in their own end. Tenacious battle for the puck along the wall. Another stop by the goaltender.
Great positioning. Once he makes that first save, he's got to be in position to make the second. Well done.
Marino's moving the puck through his own zone. Can't make the connection on the pass. Here's a chance. Anaheim's got a hold of the puck now. Oh, he had the right idea, but couldn't make that play with the pass. Moves it to Mahura. Couldn't make the connection on the play. The Penguins take it along the wall. Gibson's got the puck. Boy, he's been under fire tonight.
Been really sharp, and in a close game, you can't make a mistake that costs a critical goal.
Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession so key in today's game. Henrique's won the draw deep in the defensive zone. And they'll dump it in. Pittsburgh's got possession of the puck. Here's a shot. Point blank. And the deadlock is broken.
Well, what a crushing goal to give up. But the other guys worked hard for it. They pressed the play, and now they've got the lead.
The Ducks have gone ahead here in this third period.
They'll want to continue to be aggressive, though, James. They don't have enough of a cushion to sit back.
The Penguins get a hold of the puck off the draw.
Gensel's able to take that quick pass. He's already got a couple of goals. He's looking for a third.
Gibson's going to slow things down and opts for the whistle.
He's had a really good night. He's been on top of this game, and there's not been much that's given him trouble.
And gets a little boost to come up with the puck from off the wing with both centers tied up. Takes it from the other side of the blue line. Puck scooped up by Manson. The Ducks are in transition. Dumps it into the O-zone. Pittsburgh's gained possession along the boards. Quick pass to Crosby. Across the line along the left wall. Feeds the puck to Henrique. Anaheim's on the attack. Quick feed to Comtois.
Score!
Opponents who might have seen one of the final nails in the coffin.
Nice dish from the left wing. The Ducks gain control of the puck against the wall. Anaheim's working the transition through the middle of the ice. Here's the pass in front. Can't connect the play. Jari's going to bounce on it, and he'll take the whistle.
He's usually a pretty conservative goaltender anyway, and so the opportunity to kill the play, he's going to take it.
James and Ray with you tonight. More than half the period has been played. The Ducks have all the momentum right now, leading by two. Straight up the middle. Here they come. Here's an odd man rush. It's a two-on-one. He scores!
You're down by a couple. You want to give yourself the opportunity for a tying goal. They've done that with this one here.
Third period deficit suddenly doesn't seem so insurmountable now.
You can almost see the difference in the bench and the body language. They know they've got a chance.
Anaheim's got possession at center. Pittsburgh's got the puck along the boards. Moves it quickly over to Letang. Exploring options here inside the defensive zone. Penalty coming up. Oh, and a good textbook hit there. Whistle blown, stopping the play.
That penalty really puts them back on their heels here. Even though they got the one goal lead, now you've got to defend it short of man.
Gensel's on this special teams unit, and you know he'll be looking to use his zone ability to get them on the board here, guys.
Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. He's got a little jump. All alone! Great save!
Oh, I thought he was going to beat him, but the goalie comes up large.
Oh, they probably want a redo on that.
Oh, he's got two goals already. You know he's feeling it right now. He's carrying the puck, but I got to believe he's thinking about a third one.
Angles it over to Marino. And now he moves it to Gensel. And skilled use of the stick to poke the puck away. Pittsburgh's got it behind the net. From the defensive zone, they move the puck around. And that's poked away by Manson. Off his stick! Stops them with the glove!
Dangerous spot in the slot, and the goalie comes up big with the glove stop.
Henrique's gliding in for the face-off as this penalty kill will continue. The frozen biscuits dropped, and we are back underway here. Penalty coming up here.
We're trying to defend that lead aggressively, but they take a penalty. Now the penalty killers really have to do the job.
The Penguins have a brief 5-on-3 looming.
Well, good news for them as they trail by one. They get a power play. The key here, though, James, is to be confident without pressing. Just get the puck to the net. Make the penalty killer stress.
Tries to get this man advantage going from their own end now. Carries the puck up through center. On the heels of their blades, trying to get it out. Perfect's going to join the penalty kill here as they remain shorthanded. Handles the puck. Into the offensive end now. Centering feed. And he elects not to shoot and will hang on to the puck. And a solid save on the play there.
Smothered that in close chance.
Quick stop. Oh, stick save and a beaut. Gibson's on top of that for the whistle.
Pretty quickly on top of it to kill the play.
Milano's recognizing they're still shorthanded here as they get ready for the faceoff. Start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. More time off the clock as they grab the puck. Good clearing attempt to breathe. Tries to feed it over to Gensel. Great poke check on the reach.
If you can play in this 100 feet of the ice, you're going to probably win this game. Get the puck into the offensive zone with a simple, smart play. Get after it and try to forecheck.
And special teams comes up huge. Great job by the penalty killers to keep this one tight.
Well, that's a missed opportunity, isn't it? A chance to tie. They don't cash in, and now we're back to 5-on-5.
Slick feed. Toss it up in the neutral zone. Great heads-up play with the stick by Letang. And that's stolen by Sundqvist. Won the draw inside the neutral zone. They'll go to work offensively here. Oh, he's going to get called on that slash. Let's get the official decision. The Penguins are getting penalized for slashing. And their first chance to use the man advantage.
And so they'll get their first power play of the evening. At the very least, you want to make sure you get pucks to the net, win some puck battles so you retrieve the puck. You just do not want on your first power play to have a poor one, because that can leak into subsequent power plays as the game goes on.
They'll want to clear the zone here while they're trying to kill off this penalty. The Penguins have it now. Fires it into the offensive zone. Here's a short pass to Raquel. The Ducks looking against the half wall. The Penguins will kill off a few extra seconds now. Here they come. Under a minute to go in the third. Pittsburgh's goalie is on the bench. The extra attacker has jumped into the play. McKinn's gaining momentum. Anaheim's got the puck along the wall. There's a solid collision. Cross the empty net. And the traffic jam in front blocks the shot. Oh, and that's poked away in the offensive zone by Raquel. Fires to the empty net. And there it is, the empty net goal.
Well, that'll put a hold on this one. A solid performance. And once you touch in that empty net, everybody can take a little bit of a breath.
Teams are ready for the draw. The linesman about to drop the puck. McTavish has won it. Taken by Shattenkirk. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. And that carries on the stick. And the fans on their feet recognizing a solid victory here in front of them. Battle along the boards. Takes a shot. And that's all she wrote on this one as we are in the books. The Ducks dominant puck possession tonight. They started right in the docks, right?
This is the first detail of any Flames winning the draw. They've won many over the course of the night.
And they'll come out and salute the fans after the win.
Just the way it should be. You win, you salute the fans get to say thanks. I love it.